Speed ramping is a very easy to achieve effect in DaVinci Resolve, and it can also add in a little bit of dynamic to your final edits if you are able to use speed ramp transitions effectively. And in this video, I just want to show you guys how to improve on your speed ramp transitions in DaVinci Resolve 18. Stay tuned to the end, because at the end of it, I show how I use a little trick to improve upon the overall flow and smoothness of my speed ramp transitions. So here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and I have two clips already on my timeline. And if you can see, both clips have some movement in it. Both are moving from left to right. Position your playhead where you want the speed to start, or the ramping to start. So I'm going to position my playhead somewhere about here, because that's where I want the speed ramp to begin. Right click on the track and bring up the rate time controls. You can also do that with the keyboard shortcut Command R or Control R if you're on Windows. So bring up the rate time controls, and while we are still there, let's also bring up the rate time curve. All right, so here we are. I'm going to zoom in a little bit, and after zooming, you can see the controls here. I'm going to go down here, and I'm going to uncheck rate time frame, because we don't want to rate time the frame. We only want to rate time the speed. So select rate time speed from that drop down list. Now, right here, there's a couple of ways to add a speed point or keyframe to the speed. What we want to do is you can use this drop down here and select add a speed point, and it will add a speed point onto the speed line at the bottom here. Let's undo that. The other alternative you can do is use this keyframe button right here. So if you click on this keyframe button here, it does the same thing. It has a speed point or a keyframe point right here on that speed. So now that we have the keyframe, we want to be able to speed up the ending part of that clip. And to do that, there's a couple of ways you can do it. You can drag the speed line up. You can also bring your mouse over to the corner here. And once you see this double black arrowed cursor, you can hold down and click and drag to start bringing up the speed. And you can see here the speed is going up. So I'm going to undo that for now, and I'll show you my preferred method. My preferred method is to drag this up. But if you can see, once I drag up and I reach 300%, I can't go any further, right? And that's because if you look in the corners here, you can see that the limit is capped at 300 right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to position my mouse over that limit, and I'm going to drag it all the way up. Somewhere around here is fine. And now I can be able to drag past that 300% limit. So I'm going to come up and I'm going to drag this all the way up. I want to be somewhere around 1500 thereabout for this clips. Sometimes you may want to play around with that a little bit, but somewhere around here, I believe is good. If you get squished in all the way like that, you can just zoom in a bit just by holding the option key or the alt key and using your scroll wheel up to kind of zoom in on the clip a little bit more. So I want to go all the way up. I'm just going to keep going up, maybe around here, somewhere around here is fine. I will leave it somewhere around here. Now, if we play back this clip, we're going to realize that the speed is really quick. So it comes in at 100% and then boom, it jumps all the way up to about 1400 or 1500%, right? So we want to smooth that out. To smooth that out, select this keyframe. And then what you want to do is click on this easing button here. You're going to have these two handles, the left and right of the keyframe point. And what we're going to do is we're going to take those handles and we can drag them to smooth out the keyframe, this transition. So we're going to smooth it out. I'm going to smooth it out a little bit, right? Just so the speed is not too abrupt. It kind of flows in and gradually goes up. All right, so we are done with this first clip. We're going to go over to the second clip. Let's bring it a little bit closer. And what we want to do is on the second clip, we're going to ramp up the beginning of it. So I'm going to take my playhead and position it where I want that, you know, ramp to end. So I'm going to maybe put it somewhere around here. So around somewhere here, I want that speed ramp to end. So what I'm going to do is same thing, right click on the clip. Go into the menu and select rate time controls. Do it again once more and do rate time curve. The same thing, we're going to pull up on this drop down here. We're going to uncheck rate time frame and check rate time speed. So now we're going to repeat the same thing we did. I'm going to first start off by dragging the limit, the percentage limit, all the way up. Somewhere around here is okay. And then with my playhead right where I want that transition to end, I'm going to click this keyframe button here, take the speed line on this side and drag it all the way up, maybe about the same way where we dragged the first one. So I'm going to go all the way up to about 1500 thereabout for this clip. So somewhere about here is okay. Same thing, we're going to smooth out the transition. So click on this keyframe and then ease it out by clicking on that button right here. We're going to take the handles. If you can see the handles, like I said, you can zoom in to get a better view. I'm going to take these handles and drag it out a little bit to smooth everything out. All right, so now that we've done that, let me zoom out of these clips a little bit and then bring them together and join them. So now let's play this out and see what we have. Right there, you can see how smooth that transition is. So that's it. If that looks good to you, you are done. But I want to add on a little bit of spice. So what I do to spice up the speedrun transitions when I do it is to add a little bit of motion blur, because the movement is there, but there's no motion blur to that movement. It looks kind of artificial. We want to add in some motion blur to make it look more realistic. So to do that, we're going to go into the effects panel. I'm going to select the tools and I'm going to just search for an adjustment layer, right? An adjustment clip, I should say. And so I'm going to bring in my adjustment clip and put it right above the two clips like that. And what I want to do is I'm going to resize this adjustment clip so that it ends and starts and ends with the transition. So we know somewhere around here is where this transition is ending. So I'm going to bring my adjustment clip somewhere around here to end, and the start point of the adjustment clip also somewhere right here where the transition starts, somewhere like that, right? So just like that. And then now I'm going to go back into my effects panel, and inside the effects panel, I'm going to go over to the open effects tab, scroll down and look for directional blur right here. So I'm going to take my directional blur and drop it on the adjustment clip. Now let's go over to the inspector. If your inspector is not open, you can bring it up like that. And what I'm going to do is I want to see the direction in which this blur is moving, because it's a directional blur. So go over to the effects tab right here, and in the effects tab, I am going to bring up my blur strength all the way to 100. And you can see the movement is going upward. So I want to change the blur angle till I see it maybe going left to right. They're about somewhere around here is okay. And with this, I'm going to bring my blur strength back down a little bit to maybe about, you know, somewhere around here, 0.5, about thereabout. And what I want to do is I want to animate the blur strength from the beginning of the transition to the end of the transition. So I'm going to position my playhead at the beginning of this track, and I'm going to put a keyframe right here and take my blur strength all the way down to 0. So you can just type it in here, 0, and enter. And then I'm going to move this playhead over to the middle of the cut where we have the exact middle of those two clips. And then at this point, I'm going to bring my blur strength back up to where I had it, around, you know, 0.5, somewhere around here should be okay. Move that playhead over to the end of the adjustment clip. And now I'm going to add another keyframe and set it back to 0. So what we've done is that the blur strength is going to be at the strongest in the middle of the clip and fade out. Same way it's going to be fading in and then fade out that way. All right, so let's take a look at what we have done and see how this clip looks now. So as you can see, adding on that little adjustment clip with the directional blur adds a little bit more of a punch to this edit, makes it look more realistic with that panning movement. All right, guys, so that's it for doing speedrun transitions in DaVinci Resolve 18. If you like this tutorial, please consider giving it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share, like, and also subscribe to this channel. And I will see you in the next video. Stay blessed and keep creating.